Hey y'all, it's Mama D. I'm getting ready to make another stir fry recipe with summer vegetables. It's really, really good. It's healthy, it's liver friendly. So if you have liver disease, you can have this. And as you can see, I have mushrooms. I use an 8-ounce box of mushrooms. I use 3 carrots and I dice them, or I cut them so that they're pretty and attractive. I use a sweet pepper. Today I'm using a banana sweet peppers. I use 1 large onion and I cut it in chunks, and I use 1 large zucchini and I cut it in half moons. So now that I have all my vegetables cut up, I'm gonna put them all together in a bowl, just like that.
Now,
so next, I went out to my garden and I picked some basil, fresh basil, and I'm using 2 different kinds because I just really like variety. I'm using the regular basil, and I'm also using the lemon basil. The lemon basil has smaller leaves, the regular basil is bigger. So you can see the difference. This is the lemon basil, and of course I have to wash it and clean it more and pick off some of the bad areas. But so I'm using 2 different types of basils because I tend to go overboard. That's probably how I ended up like this. So that next, let me go wash this, and I'm going to tear it apart and put it in with the stir fry. Okay, so now I am going to slice the jalapeño, but first I slice it in half and I remove all the seeds so that it's not too overpowering. Okay. So now my pepper is washed and deseeded and cleaned, and this, because it is a hot pepper, you know, I try to go very thin with it, and I slice it very thin like that to put in with the recipe. So if you know, when you do get a bite of it, it's not overpowering or too hot, or, you know, some people like that. Personally, I do. I love hot very, very, very much. And so, and garlic, I go crazy for garlic. So as you can see, I slice this pepper very, very thin, so it just makes it more comfortable to eat, you know. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, so next I do my garlic. And I know the recipe only calls for 3 cloves of garlic, but like I said before, I always go overboard. And I got this little contraption here that I got from Wish. And it has a little bowl that it catches the garlic in, and it minces it up real, real good. So once I smash the garlic, which I do with my knife like this, I put it over the garlic clove, and then the peeling peels right off. And then I take this little contraption right here, and I just set my garlic clove in there like that. And it doesn't always work perfect. And I push down. Whoops, like that, and it minces the garlic through there. And sometimes, like I said, I go overboard, so I put too big of a piece in there. Whoops, they don't call me Grace for nothing. And so I put too big of a piece in there, and so then I have to hit it too hard. But anyway, you can mince it by hand if you want to. It just depends on you. Okay, so now I have abused this little machine, but I have got the garlic all minced, and I wanted to show you that when I pull it out, you know, it's all chopped up tiny, so it makes it perfect for a stir fry. And I've got my peppers, my jalapeno pepper, jalapeno, what the hino, there you are. Okay, so then this, I get my bowl that I have with my fresh mint diced up. One thing I wanted to share with y'all about the mint, the fresh mint, so you're not alarmed. a lot of times when the sun beats down on the mint, and it'll turn it black a little bit like that, but it's okay. That it's still good, just so that you know. And then I just dump my garlic in here on top, and I put my sliced jalapenos on top, and then I will add the tomato, but the tomatoes, and I chunk them up, and I will show you in a second. The tomatoes I don't add until the very last, because the tomatoes, if they cook down too much, then they peel, they don't look pretty, and they don't taste real good. We just want the tomatoes to be warmed, if you will. Okay, so I got my tomatoes sliced, but again, as I said, I don't put them in yet. I leave them for last. But the Italian seasoning, I do put in right with the stir-fry vegetables that are cut up. So, okay, I'll be back in a second to show you. We're going to start stir-frying. Okay, so I have my stove on 7. I have an electric stove, and we are going to put the olive oil in. I told you I go overboard. Okay, and then as soon as this olive oil heats up, then I will start to stir fry the vegetables. Another thing that I like and I love, and everybody will tell you, is fresh oregano. So I went out in the spice garden and I got me some of my fresh oregano, and I like to throw that right in the bottom of the oil. You can probably hear the oil sizzling over there, the olive oil. But I will show you. Okay, so I've got my oregano washed and off the stems, and I'm going to go over and put it on the in the pan. Okay, so I have my oil heated up pretty good, and my oregano, and it's going to yell at me because my oregano is still wet a little bit from washing it. But because I feel like it opens up the spice and it flavors the oil. Oh, I knew it was going to stick. It flavors the oil. So I just kind of, you know, saute it around. Oh, my camera's getting bubbled. Okay, I'll be back. So I have had this covered, and I've been cooking it for a few minutes. And we don't want these vegetables to get too done, because we want a little crisp freshness to them. So I'm going to turn them off, and we are going to make the stir fry sauce. Okay, so we're ready to do the sauce. I got my zest in there, my lemon zest, some of it. And this is my peanut butter spoon from scraping the peanuts out. You can see that it's a little chunky, but if you don't have any kind of a processor to do your peanuts, you can buy this at the store. I got this, I believe I got this at either Walmart or Meyers, and it's 100% peanuts, so it's organic. As you can see, the ingredients is just peanuts, because we want to go organic as much as we can, so there's not chemicals in our food, so our liver can heal. So this is peanut butter that I've ground up. As you can see, there's chunks of peanuts in it. Whoops. So I have 1 cup here, and I'll scrape that into my bowl just as good as I can without wasting any. Okay, so there's the peanuts, or the creamed peanuts. And then I need 3 tablespoons of honey. So we're going to do 3 tablespoons. There's 1. That eliminates the sugar, because the body processes honey, well, the liver, I should say, because it's a natural, raw, organic honey. The liver processes it easier without having to work overtime. So that's the reason we're using honey instead of sugar, because we want all natural if we can get it for our liver so that it can process it. Okay, so I had to rinse that. And next, I need some Himalayan salt. So I just do very little that I can because salt is not good for the liver either. So we try to do something natural like Himalayan. So that's what I use personally is Himalayan salt. And then also we need 2 teaspoons of olive oil. Because we do need that, you know, the oil for the paste, for the stir fry sauce. And then next, we want 2 teaspoons of chili, Asian chili. I don't know if you can see that. That light, I think, kind of restricts it. But it's just like hot pepper ground up with garlic. And you can buy it at Meijer's or Walmart. That's, and we need 2 teaspoons, but as I said before, I always overdo. And I like hot, so I'm doing a heaping tablespoon. When I first created this recipe, you know, I ended up putting more hot pepper into my my dish after I ate it because it wasn't hot enough. So then now more lemon zest and the lemon juice from one lemon. Now in my first recipe, as you'll see in the ingredients, I have 3 tablespoons of lemon plus the lemon zest. But this is the thing. As you cook, you're going to acquire your own taste and how much of what you want in that. And so, you know, you can take away or give more according to your taste. Now we need 3 tablespoons of mustard. A lot of people use Dijon mustard, but I personally prefer the yellow mustard. Along with the lemon juice and the peanut butter and the hot pepper, I just think it does better. My personal preference. So you can use Dijon mustard if you want, or you can use yellow mustard or hot mustard or whatever your preference is. You can develop my recipe to fit your own. And then I just mix this all up together, which is going to create our stir fry base sauce. See, and that peanut butter with the sour lemon and the sweet honey and the unique mustard flavor. And I try to create these flavors and mix them together because once you have fatty liver, it's very hard to adjust without salt and sugar. So for that reason, I've tried to create, mix, add, take away spices, flavors, and incorporate them to satisfy somebody that's needing to lose weight because of the fatty liver and because of the withdrawals from the sugar and the salt. It makes it easier. Okay, I'll be back in a minute. Okay, now I'm going to incorporate my sauce. I've mixed a little water in it to make it thinner so that it incorporates easily into the stir-fried vegetables. And I just pour it in and I mix it up. And then I turn my heat off. Okay, I'll be back in a minute. So now I'm ready to dish up the product. I've simmered it just for a few minutes. And I pour it on my plate. Just like so. Just like that. Put a few pretties on top. And then I put my fresh basil on top to decorate it and make it look very presentable. So it looks pretty. I hope you've enjoyed my video, and I hope you enjoy the flavors that I've combined, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Blessings from Mama D, from my table to yours.